That's nice.
What's up, guys? It's RevJ again, and I am, like, I'm deep in V-neck today. This V is just going all the way down. I haven't seen a V this deep since Eastern Europe, man. You can see, like, I got the hamburger meat hanging out here. This is ridiculous. But we're not here to talk about my ridiculous V-neck shirt. We are instead here to talk about the Drift Trike project that we started in the previous video. If you haven't watched that video, definitely go check it out now. It outlines the Mongoose Dolomite bike we started with, ripping that thing apart, and all the good parts we were able to salvage off of it. Now, the best aspect of salvaging all that stuff is, of course, it's stuff I don't have to spend money on going into this project. And since I knew what I was working with for a front wheel, tire, axle, forks, all that stuff, I could redirect my attention to the rear. So I went ahead and ordered a kart rear axle package. That's basically what we're using is racing kart parts. So that's a 1-inch axle, that's 5.5-inch kart wheels, that's kart tires. I went with a 4041 style chain and sprocket combination. So all that stuff is on the way, and now that I know the front and the rear that I'm working with, I can set about building a frame that'll kind of tie the whole thing together. Now, in my opinion, before a single piece of metal is ever cut, it is way easier to lay all this out on a computer first, so I went ahead and opened up a new doc in Photoshop and threw a few things together. All right, guys, like I said, it's way easier to lay this out on the computer first, so I opened up a new document in Photoshop where I can do some basic setup and see how this thing looks. We're starting with the existing Mongoose 26x4 front wheel and the brakes, so I'll go ahead and throw that on there. And I know I talked about keeping the original front forks as well, since they're designed to work with that style front wheel. I've also got the existing bearings and hardware on there, since none of that's going to change. Now, on top of that, I said we were going to go ahead and keep the factory style bars. I do have these flipped upside down and backwards, mostly because I think it's going to work with the trike design, but if I need to flip it around, it's just a couple bolts. Also, it's worth noting, because you can't tell in the picture, I do have the front brakes on the right hand like you'd find in a motorcycle. I hate front brakes on the left hand. It just seems unnatural to me, so if we're redoing it anyway, I'm going to go ahead and flip it here to the right side. We've got a typical 5.5 go-kart rim with a 10.5-inch tire on top of it, and just for the sake of illustrating it here, I went ahead and threw the PVC sleeve around the outside. To me, for building the frame, the most logical thing seemed like starting at the front where we have a lot of known components and working our way back and designing from there. I decided to start with the head tube and an existing angle that I wanted to work with. I decided to set the forks at about 20 to 25 degrees down here and start the head tube at that point. Now, I knew the overall height of my real entire package in the rear is going to be about 11 inches, which means the axle center line's about 5.5. So I laid out some rough ideas going from the 5.5-inch axle center height up to where I knew my head tube was going to start based on the dimensions I had for the front wheel. Basically, I did a few different Bezier curves to see what I liked and came up with a basic shape like that. It's a simple one-piece bent design, a single piece of tubing bent in really two places that gradually comes up and meets with the existing head tube. So now that the front end of this thing is connected to the main body, we've got to talk about important things like where's the engine going to sit, where's the axle going to sit, and where am I going to sit. Went ahead and designed a quick rear frame here. It doesn't look like much from this angle, but let me back out just real quickly and show an overhead. This here is a simple outline of the basic main hoop. Now, there are cross bracings and stuff in here. I just wanted to throw this up real quick so you can see roughly what this here looks like from the top. Now, that's the main frame design, but of course there is a lot more to talk about. For example, you need a place to put your feet, so I like the idea with going something like a simple highway bar that gives you a nice simple place to rest your feet and also allows you, should you want to in the future, to add a provision for a foot throttle instead of a hand throttle right down here. Now again, that's optional and we'll see what I choose here as parts start to come together. Now, as an American, I'm always tempted to go ahead and add some cup holders. Completely unnecessary, but if I'm going to use this thing to tool around at car shows, drift around in parking lots, and maybe take out on the ice, the ability to hold a nice frosty beverage, or possibly a warm beverage, is a welcome addition to anything I'm building. Speaking of holding things comfortably, gotta go ahead and throw a simple seat on it. This is just an outline, but something like a simple tractor seat or a low back farm equipment seat most likely is going to be the answer. And of course, I've glazed over something pretty important, and that's of course the motor. I went ahead and threw a couple outlines up here. This is basically the representation for the 212 or the 420. Both are available at Harbor Freight, Northern Tool, and the like. Both are pretty much the same layout with two slightly different increases in size between the 212 and of course the larger 420. Now, on top of that, of course, you need a clutch,
Rear axle, rear brakes, and I even added a simple handbrake setup. All the hidden stuff you see here is kind of tucked away. Rear brakes are optional, but they're a great idea. Rear sprockets, of course, necessary. You have a centrifugal clutch and a chain. Well, there we go. It's a pretty simple layout for a drift trike, probably pretty similar to what you might have seen before. Of course, it'll have custom twists and things that we're going to do differently, and a lot of that will develop along the way. One of the things I do want to do differently is add some sort of roll bar type to the back. Now the idea behind this, it'll give me some rear support and stability to the frame, it'll cage in the engine here just in case this thing were ever to flip over, and it also gives me a simple point to lift and tilt onto should I need to transport this thing and load it on and off of trailers. And speaking of trailers, yeah, that's a small hitch ball. Now it's probably not something I'm ever going to use, and it probably won't make its way into the final design of this thing, but part of me likes the idea of being able to tow around something like a wagon or possibly move a small trailer if I really needed to. Again, it's a lot easier to do this on the computer when you're just messing around, because a click of a button can make the whole thing go away, but for now, I'm going to leave it in the design because I wouldn't think it'd be the worst addition, and it could kind of make it fun. Now, of course, an important part of the way anything looks is the overall aesthetic of it, which means a final paint job and color choices. I'm going to go ahead and keep the front rim the same with the powder-coated outer hoop, but for the main body, the main frame, I'm not exactly sure. We've got a bunch of different options, so let's take a look at a couple that I think might be cool. Now to start with, we've got the classic white. It goes great with the existing red, and there's something about the way that a white powder-coated or a white painted bent tube just looks. I think it's a clean look and it's pretty cool, but of course I'm never against going with a slightly more, I guess, ridiculous color. We could go, let me get it up here, we could go, for example, with something much brighter, like a red to match the wheel, the all red look, of course, kind of red and black once you do the bars and the seat and everything like that. I don't love it, I don't hate it, I think all red is just not quite my style, and I want more contrast, which is why I kind of like the white better. We could go all the way to the other end of the spectrum with a black. Now I'm going to go a little lighter just so you guys can see definition here. And black would be pretty cool. Again, we've got the black and red look. The black tubing always looks cool, although you do lose some detail in the work if there's good welds and good bends. It'd be nicer to show them off with a more aggressive color, but black is always a pretty rad possibility. Now, if you guys know my channel, you know I have a penchant for a color that I sort of refer to as Robin's Egg Blue, a lot more like the color that is currently on my truck, which is sort of your lighter hue, almost pastel blue, not quite, baby blue, Robin's Egg Blue is the way I like to phrase it, something like that. Now, I think that's a pretty rad look. You've got an awesome color that really stands out. It's light enough to give a lot of definition to the tubing, and it does do a pretty good job going with the front wheel color combination. I am tempted to go with this, especially because if I threw it in the back of the truck with that same paint on it, it would kind of match, and the car nerd in me likes the possibility of towing a matching vehicle in the back of another cool-ass matching vehicle. So I set it back to white. While we are going to stick with a design pretty much similar to this, we have a ton of room in terms of what the overall finish is going to look like with paint and everything like that, so let me know in the comments below or hit me up on social media. I'll have it here on screen, and let me know what way you guys would paint these things. Would you go with the white? Would you go with the blue, the all red, the black? There's lots of possibilities, and I'm sure there's a whole bunch that I haven't even thrown out there, so of course let me know, guys, what you would want to go with. And now that I've got a drawing and a layout I'm happy with, I can go ahead and start to transfer my image on the screen into steel in real life.